Hello dear students, welcome back to the class A, that is the rational numbers. So in the rational numbers we have started with the definition of rational numbers. So what is the definition of rational numbers? The numbers expressed in the form of P by Q. The numbers expressed in the form of P by Q, where Q is not equals to 0, are called rational numbers. And P and Q, you know that P and Q are integers. So this is the first concept in the first video we have studied, that is P and Q are integers and Q is not equals to 0. And also we have taken the example 1 by 2, where 2 is not equals to 0. And also we have studied the properties of rational numbers in the form of addition, and that in that we have studied the two properties, that is first one we have studied, that is first one is closure property. First one you have studied, the closure property in the addition of rational number. Second one you have studied, the commutative property. Commutative property. So these two concepts we have studied in the last class. In this class, in this video, you are going to study the associative property of rational numbers in the form of addition. So that is third one you are going to study, that is what you are going to study, that is associative property. Associative property of rational numbers in the form of addition. Rational numbers. So associative property of rational numbers in the form of addition you have studied. So our statement says, if A by B comma C by D comma and E by F are three rational numbers, which means, that is A by B plus of C by D plus of E by F, which is equals to A by B plus C by D plus of E by F. Okay, so this is your definition, says, that is, I'll choose this as small f. Okay, so see here, associative property of rational numbers, if A by B comma C by D and E by F are three rational numbers, then A by B plus of C by D plus of E by F, which is equals to A by B plus C by D plus of E by F. Okay, so this is the associative property of rational numbers. So I choose one example, we'll come to know what it mean by this associative properties of rational numbers. We'll solve one example. I choose 2 by 5. C by D I choose as 1 by 4. And E by F I choose as minus 3 by 5. Okay, so this is one example number one, just you have to verify and you have to note down. So what does our associative property says? A by B plus of C by D plus of E by F, which is equals to A by B plus of C by D plus of E by F. E by F. In this property you have to verify. So A by B is 2 by 5. So A by B each is equals to 2 by 5 plus C by D is 1 by 4 plus E by F, that is minus 3 by 5, that is minus 3 by 5, okay, which is equals to again 2 by 5, a by b is again 2 by 5 plus c by d which is equals to 1 by 4 plus e by f which is equals to minus 3 by 5. Okay, so this is your the numbers or examples which are given here. First we will verify this. So all of you can see now 2 by 5 as it is plus sign, 1 by 4 plus into minus is minus 3 by 5 which is equals to 2 by 5 plus of 1 by 4 which is equals to minus of 3 by 5. Now just all of you have to verify here. So see here all of you, 2 by 5 plus of, just all of you know what is the LCM now. One is even number, one is odd number. What you have to do? Directly you have to multiply. That is 5 4s are 20. LCM is 20. So again 4 5s are 20. 5 4s are 20. So 5 1s are 5. Again 4 3s are 12. Okay. So 4 3s are 12. Okay. Which is equals to again 5 4s are, you are having as 20. Again this is 5 4s are 4 5s are. So again 4 2s are 8. Again plus of 5 1s are 5. Which is equals to minus 3 by 5. Okay, now see 2 by 5 which is 12 minus 5 which is equals to minus 7 by 20. Which is equals to again that is 8 plus 5. 8 plus 5 is again you are having as 13. So 8 plus 5 is 13 by 20. Minus of 3 by 5. Okay, so see here, between 5 and 20, the LCM is 20. I'll solve here. Continue here. That is LHS part. That is LCM is you are having as 20. Means here 5 4s are 20 1s are. So 4 2s are 8. Minus of 7 1s are 7. So 8 minus 7, again 20 and 5 LCM is 20, again this is 1s are, again this is 5 4s are, okay. So again this is 13, 13 1s are 13, 4 3s are 12, which is equals to again you know that 8 minus 7 which is equals to 1 by 20 and 13 minus 12 which is equals to 1 by 20. Means here LHS is equals to RHS, means we can say associative property holds good for rational numbers. So all of you can see here, once again I will do explain here, a by b plus of c by d plus of e by f which is equals to a by b plus c by d plus of e by f. So a by b we have chosen as 2 by 5 plus operation as it is, c by d we have chosen as 1 by 4 plus operation as it is, e by f means minus 3 by 5 which is equals to 2 by 5 plus of 1 by 4 plus minus 3 by 5. One bracket you have to open and one bracket you have to close and last one you have to open. Okay, so 2 by 5 as it is plus sign as it is, 4 and 5, 1 by 4 plus into minus is minus, that is again 2 by 5 plus of 1 by 4 minus of 3 by 5. Now see here, 2 by 5 plus 4 and 5 having the LCM as 20, 4 5s are 20, 5 4s are 20. Now see the numerator, 5 1s are 5, minus sign as it is, 4 3s are 12. So 12 minus of 5 which is equals to 7, so minus sign you have to keep this as it is. Similarly, 5 4s are 20, again 5 4s are 20, 4 5s are 20. See the numerator, 2 4s are 8, plus sign as it is, 1 5s are 5. Minus of 3 by 5. So minus of 3 by 5. Now we can see 2 by 5 plus into minus is again minus. Minus of 7 by 20 which is equals to 8 plus 5 which is equals to 13 by 20 minus of 3 by 5. This part I have solved here. That is 5 and 20 you are having the LCM as 20. That is 8 minus 7 which is equals to 1 by 20. 13 minus 12, which is equals to 1 by 20. Means LHS is equals to RHS. Means we can conclude here, associative property holds good for addition. Associative property holds good for addition. Now we are going to study some more properties, last two properties in this rational number. That is your last concept you see here of in properties. That is first one, you are going to study the additive identity. That is your fourth concept, additive identity of rational number. Additive identity of rational number. Additive identity of rational numbers. Okay, so what does this additive identity of rational number says? 0 is additive identity of rational number, which means 0 is added to any rational number, we get a rational number. Means here 0 is the additive identity of rational number. 0 is additive identity of rational number. Identity of rational number. Zero is additive identity of rational number, which means when zero is added to any rational number, when zero is added to any rational number, we get a rational number. So this is the additive identity statement. So 0 is additive identity of rational number, which means when 0 is added to any rational number, we get a rational number. So see here, A by B is a rational number, plus when added to 0, and when 0 is added to any rational number, that is A by B, we always get a rational number A by B. Okay, similarly one example, I choose A by B I choose as 2 by 3. Means when 2 by 3 is added to 0, again 0 is added to 2 by 3, I always get a rational number. That is 2 by 3. So 2 by 3 when is added to 0, when 0 is added to 2 by 3, I always get a rational number. So this is 0 means additive identity of a rational number. So next property you are having as additive inverse of a rational number. Additive inverse of a rational number. So that is a last property in the properties of rational number. That is your fifth property. It is additive inverse of rational number. So additive inverse of rational number property says, for every rational number A by B, there exists a rational number minus A by B. For every rational number, there exists a rational number. For every rational number A by B, I choose. For every rational number A by B, there exists a rational number minus A by B. Okay? For every rational number A by B, there exists a rational number minus A by B, means such that A by B plus of minus A by B, means which is equals to A by B plus into minus is minus A by B. Again A by B minus of A by B, which is equals to 0, means which is equals to 0. Means our statement says, that is, for every rational number a by b, there exists a rational number minus a by b, means such that a by b plus of minus a by b, which is equals to 0. Check whether 7 by 11, example number 1, that is, check whether 7 by 11 and minus 7 by 11 are additive inverse of each other, are additive inverse of each other. We have to check this. What we have to check? 7 by 11 and minus 7 by 11 are additive inverse of each other, means 7 by 11 plus of minus 7 by 11, which is equals to 7 by 11 as it is, minus of plus into minus is minus 7 by 11. Means again your LCM is, again you are having as 11, 7 minus 7, which is equals to 0 by 11. So again 0 by 11, you are anything, so 0 divided by 11 is again 0 only. Okay, so answer we get 0. So additive inverse holds good for this addition and subtraction. So see here, for every rational numbers a by b, there exists a rational number minus a by b, such that a by b plus of minus a by b, which is equals to 0. 7 by 11 and minus 7 by 11 are the additive inverse of each other. 7 by 11 plus of minus 7 by 11. If I solve this, 7 by 11 minus of 7 by 11. 11 is LCM. Subtract numerator, 7 minus 7, which is equals to 0 by 11, which is equals to 0. Means here additive inverse is satisfied the equation. I hope so you have understood all these concepts, and all of you have to note down the properties of rational number and additive identity, additive inverse, and you have to send me on my WhatsApp number.